war that is very much a reenactment of what happened 500 years ago. So imagine you are in Italy. You are in Florence. And it's such a beautiful day. There's marketplace. There's families. There's children. There are unsavory thieves in the corners. And you see a troupe of players telling a story and reenacting stories of love, stories of adventure, and stories of fear. We will give them all to you today, and I will show you a few little pieces of what the characters are like. Now, when I show them to you, you will need to learn your part. You will need to hiss at the villains. You will need to applaud for the heroes. And you will need to sigh for the lovers. Aww. So first, the villain. We have a villain. His name is Pantalone. Where is he now?
Pantalone!
He is the richest man in all of Venice. He is a nasty, selfish merchant who grabs on to every little ducat he can.
Of course I am!
Yes, and he's nasty. So, when you see him come on stage, I want you to hiss. Ready? One, two, three. Well done, my friend. Go find someone to steal from. Yes. And then we have a hero. We have many heroes, but we have one that is the Capitano Spavento!
Did I hear you call for a hero?
Oh, Capitano, I'm so glad you're here. This audience has come to see you, and they love your Spanish magnificence.
Oh, so magnificent.
Yes, so when you see the hero, please, I want you to applaud with all the great joy and happiness. Now, the last thing, there's always love in a story. And so, the essence of our love is our true lady, Isabella. She is the sweet daughter of Pantalone. So whenever she comes around, I want you to sigh with the greatest heart that you have. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, such adorable. Isabella, you, I'm sure, will be married any day now. It will happen, I guarantee. So now today, we are going to see what happens when Pantalone meets his rival. In fact, we will do so knowing that the queen is coming. So there will be tension, there will be fear, there will undoubtedly be bloodshed as we present to you the story of vices and virtues.
Invitation to the Queen's
ball. A jubilee ball.
A jubilee ball. Oh, but it says here that only the most virtuous must will be able to attend. So I do believe I heard a rumor that though the group that is determined to be the most virtuous will get favor from the Queen, like contracts and positions and money. We our household must be the most virtuous. I think we can do that, don't you? So we must summon the household. Oh, Isabella, Capitano,
yes, Papa,
Flaminia, Franceschina,
yes, Papa.
Come quickly. Come. Oh, Marichino, too. Okay. Oh, yes, yes,
yes. Yes, for, Papa.
I have the most wonderful news.
For
we have all been invited to the Queen's Jubilee Ball. But only the most virtuous people are allowed to attend. So we must be on a, we must be the most virtuous. But surely we can.
Yes.
Isabella, what would you?
Oh, Papa, you know me so well.
Well, and And what did that do, Flaminia?
Oh, Papa, I am just kindness itself. I just love going about and performing acts of kindness to others and giving of myself and treating those who deserve kindness with kindness. Yes.
And Capitano.
What is?
Are you surely a brave?
Yes, surely, surely. I am, of course, the most brave.
And what of you, Francesquina?
Ah, I am ever diligent protecting your lovely prize daughters and their innocence until they are married.
Ah, yes. Of course, of course. And my good friend, Dottore, what would your virtue be?
After constant thought and thinking, I shall be, but it's very difficult. Very hard to be humble.
Oh, humble, yes, I believe you are the most humble person I know. Yes, yes. Well, we must all prepare. Yes, we should. Okay. Well, I'll be Arlecchino. You are Arlecchino. Great! Go! Get on! All right, we must all prepare. Francesquino, you stay here and clean up.
Yes, Pantolonia.
Get prepared,
yes.
Has anybody seen Victoria? I mean, just, I'm looking for Victoria. And I can't find her. Just, do you know where she is? You
have,
oh!
Oh, Francesquino,
it's you.
Oh, my goodness, I'm sorry. There might have been someone from Pantolonia's house.
Oh, Francesquina, I am so glad to see you. You are my most faithful servant. Oh, I'm so glad you finally got a job within the Pantalone household so you can spy for me.
It has been my delight and joy to spy for you and to learn from you, the Empress of Evil.
Yes, so thank you. Have you been practicing the laugh? The laugh.
The laugh. Okay.
Let me hear it.
Oh,
that's lovely! Oh, that's just tingles down my spine! Oh, you're getting really, really good at that. I'm so glad to have you in the household. I'm happy to teach you all of my evil ways. Because we, as women, need to resort to these ways in order to get ahead in this world. This is a world of men, but we have ways of making things for ourselves.
Yes.
Now then, what's been going on in the Pantalone household?
Okay, there is a big news.
That big! That's really big!
Do you think that's very big? That's very big to me.
Big, I can't believe it.
Very big. Pantalone and his household have been invited to the Queen's Ball.
The Queen's Ball?
The Queen.
The Queen.
The Queen.
The Queen! My goodness, the Queen's
Queen!
She is all powerful because you know the Queen is the powerful one in that match. The Queen knows who to give special treatment to, who to give merchanting deals to. I bet Pantalone will really want to suck up to the Queen at that ball.
But the thing is, only the most virtuous will be her favor. I mean, just a gasp, but Pantalone thinks his household will qualify.
Oh, no! Virtuous! Pantalone's household? Virtuous? How could they be virtuous? Pantalone is the most vice-ridden man I've ever known. He is the donkey to my Andalusian stallion.
He is the vinegar to your honey.
Yes! He is the apple to my orange. In fact, I will find a way to bring him down using this fake virtue he believes he has. He and the entire household. Oh, we will find a way. I will meet you later. I will develop a plan.
Excellent.
So I would say, Dottore, I believe that my virtue is generosity. Yes, yes. generosity?
You are very well known, my friend Pendahoni, for generosity.
Yes, of course. After all, I gave 2 ducats to the orphans just last week.
He fell out of your purse, if I remember correctly.
And I would have got those orphans if I hadn't trapped. Generosity. Yes, and what of you?
I am going to outdo everyone with humility.
Humility?
As the grand jubilee ball of the queen, yes, they will know me as the humblest. They will know that I epitomize humility, that I am the epitome of humility, and that I, at the ball, yes indeed,
yes.
I will be the most humiliated.
Of course you will be. Yes. So I only hope that, that evil diver of mine, Victoria, she just makes my skin crawl, is not invited. She better not be invited. For she has been my nemesis for nigh on 20 years.
It's just a no good thing.
But perhaps we should move along. Yes. After all, we must make sure that we have all the appropriate things ready.
And you shall market the wines to the king.
That is true. I have presented an offer to provide the wine for a suitable fee to the ball, and I'm waiting to hear if they will accept it.
They will accept it. You know all things about wine.
Yes.
The winiest man at all. Everyone knows you for your whining.
Yes, I am whining. Yes. I must consult with the rest of the household.
I remember that line. Is that specifically the truth? Yes. I recommend it. I must go to the library.
Oh, yes, he must go to the library. Isabella! Isabella, come out here!
Yes, Papa, I'm sorry. I just got back. I've been shopping.
You've been shopping?
Shopping. I bought this new pearl necklace.
Oh!
New shoes!
New shoes!
For the ball! In fact, I bought several pairs of shoes.
Oh, you're going to bankrupt me! So you teach your sister how to be honored. You must coach her in the virtues. I must go see to my strongbox. I hope there's enough pity cats here.
That was Lavinia. Minion. Eight women. Yes. Hi, Lavinia.
Hello,
Isabella. Papa wanted me to teach you about being innocent and honorable.
Did he send someone to show you how to do that?
You know he sent me to teach you because I am the most innocent and honorable young lady in all of this.
Well, you certainly caught a good show.
Yes. You think you're so fine. Just look at you. You're like the meanest, nastiest, most horrible girl in all of this.
Yes, you're not.
I'm too.
Yes, she just went that way.
Do you wish to see her?
Ah,
this gives us some comfort.
Chicago bound anyway. Well, I was coming back from seeing the fish, and we were playing deep into the night, and I heard a hard blast footsteps behind me, and I turned ready for a front defense, but I did not see a man's.
No!
No!
What did I see?
I don't know!
No, you were not there! Let me tell you, it was a beast. It was a ugly beast.
No.
So with your body?
Yes.
Take a deep breath. Take it out. come. Relax. A little bit of humildad.
One more time.
No!
extra shots. We need this to look official, like a real royal document. We need something like a seal, like a royal seal. Do you know where I can get one? Have you seen one around here? A royal seal? Oh, Antarctica! Let's go to Antarctica! Oh, look! We need some good stuff. Yes!
You want seals?
Yeah,
I got seals.
I want to get my country. No, I like that. Oh, a seal merchant would have most needed one. Do you have maybe a royal seal?
Royal seal for what?
For a document so that it looks very, very royal and official. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, this is magnificent. Thank you. Oh, how perfect. Look, this will do just the job. Oh, look at that. Doesn't that look royal? Don't you want to bow to that? It makes you want to go, yes, that's just exactly what royal seals look like. Oh, it's perfect. Now you take it to Pentagon and make his whole house go mad, and then we will bring him down.
Magnificent Pantalone, I have heard the virtues of your entire household. my most diligent servant, Francesca.
Madam, your majesty.
Yes?
I am ever diligent in protecting the innocence and honor of his eldest daughter and promoting the kindness of his second daughter. And let me tell you, it is a full-time job.
Yes, I see that your diligence may not be enough for what's going on in this household.
Well,
I wonder if it's true diligence, or maybe she's slacking.
Oh, well, let me introduce my first daughter, Isabella. Yes, most pure.
I am the most honorable and innocent of all ladies in this village.
Innocent. It looks like you are completely innocent. Yes, yes, I think my spies saw how innocent you were with the three men sneaking out of your room last week.
What?
Three men?
Yes, yes, my spies right here.
Well, your majesty, then let me introduce my second daughter, the kindness of the
Yes, yes, anyone who decides that she's better than her sister absolutely does not reveal kindness to the world.
Yes, yes, this is my good friend, Dr. Grazia.
Yes, excellent, excellent. You can keep doing that. Yes, I have heard, in fact, Dr. You are, in fact, the most humiliated man in all of Venice. Yes, and you, working with this one, Pantalone! No, I do not see virtue in you at all. Pantalone, what do you have to say for yourself? This is a travesty. This is not virtue. These are vices, everyone.
I must throw myself upon your mercy, O Queen, for your majesty has shown me that I, Pantalone, are not generous. I am selfish. I get that.
Yes, I knew it!
Then tell me, how far are you walking?
I knew it!
You!
I wanted you to say it in front of all these people! To be witnessed by the most noble knights in the realm! Generous, and then he took it back. He is not generous at all. In fact, he is selfish. The most selfish and undeserving man in all of Venice. Good luck getting any merchant deals at the Queen now!
Thank you.
parts of the music.